Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakin from Nail Nails. In this video, we are going to do my ring finger. And we're going to do a rose, and it's going to be like a dying rose. Keep watching, all will be revealed. This is going to give me finger ache because this finger is quite hard to hold like that. Hey! Now I know how JJ really feels when I try to get her to hold her finger straight. The poor girl. What we're going to do is I've already prepped this nail because I took nails off previously. I'm going to fit a sculpting form now. We will be using clear acrylic powder, black acrylic powder, and white acrylic powder and black gel polish.
And whatever else.
Might even put a bit of gold glitter in there as well. Gonna do a stiletto nail. If you don't know how to fit a form for a stiletto nail, we have a video for that, don't we?
Do we?
Yeah, we have a video just for that.
Well, we have a video for how to do a stiletto.
Yeah.
I don't know if we have a video on how to fit a form for a stiletto.
I think we do. Yeah. I think it's oldish.
It's oldish.
Like over a year old.
Oh, that'd be crimped hair. Crimped hair, Kirsty.
Yeah. There we are, that's on. We're ready to roll. I'm gonna prep this with my product, so I'm gonna dehydrate the nail. Then I'm going to prime with the acid-free primer. I'm going to do two coats of this. I'm going to put a very thin layer of clear acrylic towards the end because I want some strength.
Give me strength.
Give me strength.
Is that like a saying down here?
Yeah.
Like when you're frustrated?
Yeah. Give me strength. Now we're going to use pure black acrylic powder. You want to use this really thin because we're just using it for colour. Nice and neat around the cuticle area. Any acrylic powders that have a lot of pigment in will want to stick to your brush a little bit more than, you know, your core powders. I remember when I used to wear my nails this long. I will definitely be taking these nails down. See what I do for you. See how kind I am to you. I put really long nails on that I'm never going to be able to keep. I'm quite sad about it really.
Why did you do it so long?
Because they look better. They do look better.
It's your left hand.
I know, but I just think I'll struggle at football.
It's not football till Monday, so.
No, it's football Saturday.
Well, you've got 3 days of keeping them then.
Yeah, I might do.
To get used to it.
Then I might end up going, they said, guys, go! Cut you off! Right, so we're going to let that set. And we're going to use Mega White. Then we're going to create with the white acrylic powder some beautiful flowers. Going to create that croissant shape first. And when I press this, it will move to about there. I need to be aware of that. Not ready to press. Because it's not ready to press, I am going to start another rose here. we've got the first petal of that rose. And we've got the first petal of this little rose here. And you see how when you press it, it gives you some shading straight away. I'm going to work on two of them at a time. I'm going to fit a rose in here as well. Then I'll fill in some spaces with leaves. I'm going to add a little bit of glitter. So I've got gold superfine glitter and I've got chunky glitter, which is in bronze. I'm not going to add loads, just a little smidge. Clear acrylic and just wet the area that I'm going to pour it on. I do have gold finger in my head, running round in my head. Goldfinger.
He's the man.
The man with the Midas touch. Now, because this is still quite thin and soft, I am going to give it a bit of a pinch, just with my fingers. But then I'm going to encapsulate now. And it looks beautiful like it is, but we're going to make it even better. Right, so what I've got here is I've got a dampened dish and we've got some max adhesion in there. And what we're going to do is we're going to drop a little bit of Serious Black. Oh, God, that looks amazing. Get it mixed up. We're mixing potions again. I do like mixing a potion. So we've made a black, well, grey acrylic liquid. And what we're going to do, we're going to pick up a bead of clear. And look, it makes it go grey. How cool is that? And what that's going to do is add shading to the rose and the leaves. Can you see? Look at that. That's so cool. I'm not going to fully encapsulate with that. I'm going to put some clear over this now, because I still want to be able to see the design. If I do too much, if I put too much of that colour that we've just mixed on, if we put too much of that on, you'll lose the definition of the rose. We don't want that. So when I said it was like a dead rose, well, I kind of meant that it's not a bright one. It's, you know, it's a little bit grey and wilted. It's not like a pure white rose. So I've just encapsulated with clear. I'm going to let that set up a little bit and then we will pinch this. Now we're going to pinch. Then we can take the foam off. Now I'm going to file. I'm going to do my normal filing routine. Don't worry if you hit the roses as you file, like I'm going to show you now. You see how you hit it like that? That is cool. It looks really cool. So don't worry about that. It adds to the effect. Going to buff this to make it nice and smooth. Dust that off. I'm going to wipe over with acetone. And then I'm going to seal with Mega Gloss. Because I want it mega glossy. I love putting Mega Gloss over the top. I mean, look, it just really shows up the full design. I'll pop that into the lamp. And you see how adding the black to the monomer really makes it more 3D. I think it definitely adds to it, don't you think? It makes it more 3D. And it now matches my other nails. Ooh, we're getting there. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that video. One day I'll have a ring on that. Just not yet. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. All of the products we've used today will be listed below. And I'll see you guys in the next video where we're going to do my pinky.